Hi children, how are you all? Happy to welcome you all to this max session. And now we are dealing with a very interesting chapter, triangles and its properties. And you will be eagerly waiting for this class. Okay, before getting into the class, let's see a small trick. Okay children, are you all ready for the trick? Okay, think of a number. First step, you have to think of a number. It can be a single digit number or double digit or something bigger than that also. Think a number. Now, multiply it by 3. You have to multiply by 3. If you have thought of a number 10, multiply it by 3, you will get 30. Okay? Then, add 6 to it. After multiplying by 3, you would have got an answer. With that answer, add 6. Not with the number that you have taught. Okay. Now divide it by 3. Divide it by 3. You would have got an answer. Divide that answer by 3. It is very simple. You can think of a small number, multiply it by 3, add 6 and divide by 3. And the last step now you have to do is subtract the number that you have taught in the first step. You would have thought of a number, no, in the beginning. Subtract that number with the answer that you have got now after division. In division, you will not get any remainder. You will get exactly remainder to be 0. Only one quotient you will be there. From that quotient, subtract the number that you have got. Completed your calculation? Now I will say you the answer. The answer that you have got now is 2. Okay. You would have played all such games with your friends, I believe. And you can make your own game by tracing out the logic and trick behind this. Okay. This is your activity today for fun. Okay. Just make, you can think of some other trick also. You can change the number here 363 and the answer also. You can make same type of tricks on your own and show your friends and your younger ones that you are great genius in max. Okay children, okay, come on. And today is before getting into the class, let us have a small recap of whatever we have learned in this chapter. To start with, we learned what is median. Median is the line segment joining the vertex and the midpoint of the opposite side. And we will have three medians in a triangle. All these three medians meet at a point called centroid and it divides the median in the ratio 2:1. And then we learnt about altitude. Again, it's the line segment which is perpendicular from the vertex to the opposite side. And all these altitude meet at a point called orthocenter. Then we have learnt about perpendicular bisector. These two are both perpendicular, but here it bisects the opposite side. So these three perpendicular bisect meet at a point called circumcenter. Then angular bisector meets at a point called incenter. Okay, after that, what did we learn? Yes, it is about exterior angle property. We have 6 exterior angles, isn't it? Do you remember? In clockwise, you will have 3 exterior angle. In anti-clockwise, you will have 3 exterior angle. If an lines are extended in the triangle. So this exterior, one exterior angle is equal to sum of 2 opposite interior angles. Every exterior angle will have 2 opposite interior angles and their sum will be equal to this exterior angle. Okay, then we learnt about angle sum property of a triangle. What does it states? The total measure of all the 3 angles of a triangle is 180. Based on these properties, we found the value of x and y, which is nothing but the angles in a triangle. Hope you remember all these things. And what is the final property that we learned? Yes, this is the last thing that we discussed in previous session. Sum of the lengths of 2 sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. Okay, if I add the length of 2 sides, it will be surely greater than the third side. If it is not greater than that, what will happen? We will not have a triangle. It will not form a triangle itself. Is it clear, children? And you all would have completed first problem in that exercise. Whether the given measurement will form a triangle will not form a triangle. You would have added up 2, 2 together and you would have seen whether it is greater than the third sign. If it is S in all the three categories, we can say that it forms a triangle. Even if it is not satisfying one pair, we can say it cannot form a triangle. Hope it is clear, my dear children. And today we are going to discuss few more problems that is there in the exercise. Here is the second question. Take any point O in the interior of a triangle PQR. Here we have a triangle PQR. We have O to be the interior of the triangle. Is OP Wait, let me convert this into a pen. Yes. Is OP and OQ is greater than PQ? Is it greater than PQ? Is OP plus OQ greater than PQ? Yes or no? Why it is greater than PQ? Because OPQ forms a triangle. Do we have a triangle or not? Yes, we have a triangle. If it has to be a triangle, what condition it should satisfy? Sum of the two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. That is what they have written here. So it's very simple to answer it. Is in triangle OPQ, we have OP plus OQ greater than PQ. Whatever they have given us, the same thing you have written. Because we have stating it yes. What is the reason to state it as yes? Because sum of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. This is the reason it is must. If there is no reason stated, you will not get any marks. Okay. Reason is must in all these things. And similarly, tell me about OQ plus OR. Where is OQ? Again, here. And OR, here. You use scale and pencil to draw this line. It's impossible for me to draw a straight line here. Is it clear, children? So again, does it form a triangle? Yes, it forms a triangle. So again, the same reason, sum of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. You have to state it as I have shown. Even for the third thing, you have the same thing. OR plus OP. Again, it forms a triangle. Isn't it? In any way, it forms a triangle. If I ask you PR plus PQ is greater than RQ, again it forms a triangle. In any order if I take, it forms a triangle. But if I take an exterior point here, like L, and if I ask you LP and LR is greater than LQ, do you understand my question? LP plus LR is greater than LQ. Yes, it is greater than LQ, but we will do it in two different steps. That is of higher order, but here we have to say this LP, LR and LP is greater than PR first. Then we will say LQ, LP plus LQ is greater than PQ. Then we will relate it with that. Is it clear, children? Okay, now you can have the thing I insist here is they may give a point interior of a triangle or exterior of a triangle. But the concept is sum of two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. Is it clear? Okay, now let us move to the next question. Here AM is the median of a triangle ABC. AM is the median. It means it divides the side BC into two equal halves. AB plus BC plus CA is equal to twice AM. I have to prove this. How to prove? Do you have any idea? How many triangles are there here? Yes, we have three triangles. We know AB plus AC is greater than BC, or AC plus BC is greater than AB. You will have three conditions if I have this triangle. What are the other two triangles we have? I have AMB is one triangle. AMC is another triangle. Can I state the same definition in these two triangles? The last property, sum of two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. Yes. My objective is I want AM. It's greater than AM. Isn't it? So I will add AB plus BM. Can I have it like that? AB plus BM is greater than AM. See, AB plus BM is greater than this AM. Do you understand how I say this statement? See, in triangle AMB, I have AB plus BM greater than AM. I mark it as 1. Why I stated this reason? Because we know that sum of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. Similarly, in the next half of the triangle, what is the name of this small triangle? AMC. In this triangle also, I can say AC plus MC is greater than AM. Children, you may ask me, ma'am, why you chose AC plus MC? Why can't I write AM plus MC is greater than AC? Yes, even that it is right. But it will not help me in any way to prove this condition. I should have greater than AM. I should have greater than AM. That's why I chose the two pairs to be something other than AM. I kept this as the in the right hand side, greater than AM. What are the other things other than AM in this triangle? AC and CM. So I wrote AC plus CM is greater than AM. Is it clear why I chose this order? I want 2 AM. See here, now in equation 1 and equation 2, I got AM, AM. Now I am going to add these two equations. What will I write? AB plus AC plus BM plus CM. What is BM plus CM? Think. See the diagram and say me. What is BM and CM? BM plus CM. Add it and say me. BM. See the diagram. BM. Yes. BM plus CM. Yes. We get BC. So, I can have AB plus AC I have written and BM plus CM together I got BC, which is greater than, the same symbol is there, here 1 AM, here 1 AM. So totally how many AMs do I have? 2 AM. That is what I have to prove. I got the proof answer. Is it clear why we started with this? If you have a median, we get two triangles. In first triangle, I got one condition. In second triangle, I got another condition. And I added those two conditions to get the required result. Is it clear? Hence, it is proved. In proof problems, it is required to write hence proved. Hence, it is proved. Okay, you should not leave it just. And it can be continued to some other results also. Isn't it? So, you have to conclude by stating hence proved. Okay, now shall we move to the next question? Again, we have ABCD is a quadrilateral. Here we are going to deal with the quadrilateral. The same property. What I should have is AB plus BC plus CD plus DA is greater than AC plus BD. Hope you would have got the triangles. Which triangles we are going to consider? First, I am going to consider this ABC triangle. In this triangle, I want AB plus BC. In the left hand side, AB plus BC. So, I write AB plus BC is greater than the third side AC. Similarly, in next triangle, BDC. This triangle, BDC. I have BC plus CD is greater than BD. With that help of question only, I am writing this statement. You can ask, ma'am, we can write AC plus BC is greater than AB. Yes, it's right. But it is not useful in any way in this question. So we should be very smart in choosing the correct condition. Okay, now in triangle ADC, the next triangle ADC also we get one result. Another fourth triangle, we will get four triangles and four conditions. If you add all these, we get 2AB, 2BC, 2C. See here, here 1AB, here 1AB. So 2AB, here BC, here BC, here CD, here 1CD, here 1DA, here 1DA. So, everything we have 2. So, we got 2A, 2B, C, 2, C, A, D. So, all the 2 gets cancelled and we get the answer as A, the required answer. Hence, it is proved. Is it clear, my dear children? Okay, now let's continue in the next video with a very new concept.